In this video, you will see how to test human serum for total and high-density lipoprotein, or HDL, cholesterol levels. You will be comparing your patient against a known standard. To perform the experiment, you'll need your patient block, 2 new microfuse tubes, 4 new cuvettes with caps, a dry bath set to 37 degrees centigrade, a mini centrifuge, and your micropipettes and tips. Begin by plugging in the cord labeled with green tape and then opening LogerPro. Using the prepared blank from your patient block, wipe the cuvette and place it in the spectrometer with the clear side facing forward. Choose Experiment, Calibrate, Spectrometer 1. If the spectrometer has been on, you can choose Skip Warm-up. Click Finish Calibration, then OK or Done. Place the blank back in the patient block. To determine your patient's total cholesterol, label 2 cuvettes. Here we are using the letter P for patient and S for standard. Carefully pipette 2 mL, in other words 2,000 microliters, of the cholesterol reagent into each cuvette. Then add 20 microliters of the cholesterol standard. Make sure it is not the HDL standard, into the cuvette labeled as the standard. Cap it, rock gently to mix, and place it in the dry bath incubator for 5 minutes. After about 2 or 3 minutes, you can prepare the patient sample by micropipetting 20 microliters of your patient sample into the remaining cuvette, capping, mixing, and placing it in the dry bath for 5 minutes. When the standard has warmed for 5 minutes, remove it from the dry bath, wipe it well, place it in the spectrometer, and click Collect. Wait a few seconds and click Stop. Repeat this procedure with your patient sample when it is ready, being sure to click Save Latest Run. Use the Examine tool to read your results at 500 nanometers. In this example, the patient's result is higher than the standard. Refer to your lab manual and perform the calculations needed. The result should support what your spectra shows. Record and interpret your patient's results based on the values given in your laboratory notebook. To perform the HDL test, start by labeling the microfuse tubes to indicate your patient and balance tube. Add 500 microliters of your patient sample to the patient tube. Then add 50 microliters of HDL precipitating reagent. This reagent will pull out any non-HDL fractions from the patient sample. Close and shake the tube well. Let the sample stand at room temperature for 5 minutes. While you're waiting, prepare your balance tube by micropipetting 550 microliters of NanoPure water into the microfuge tube. As you look into the mini centrifuge, you will see a rotor with 6 holes. When you use a centrifuge, you must balance your sample by placing another balance tube, in this case the one you filled with water, directly across from your sample. When the 5 minutes is up, insert your patient sample and place the balance tube directly across from it as shown here. To start the centrifuge, just press down on the clear plastic cover. Allow the centrifuge to run for 10 minutes. While it is running, label the 2 remaining cuvettes and micropipette 2 milliliters of cholesterol reagent into each one. After 10 minutes, stop the centrifuge by pushing the silver button on the front. The rotor will stop and the lid will open automatically. Carefully remove your patient sample, taking care not to remix the contents. You should see a solid at the bottom of the tube and a light yellow liquid which contains just the HDL cholesterol above that. Remember to remove the balance tube also. Add 50 microliters of the HDL standard into the cuvette labeled as standard and rotate to mix. Place it in the dry bath for 5 minutes. After a couple of minutes, add 50 microliters of the light yellow liquid from the patient microfuge tube to the remaining cuvette. Mix and warm for 5 minutes. While you're waiting, if you haven't already, connect your spectrometer and calibrate it as shown previously in this video. When 5 minutes has passed, wipe the standard cuvette, place it in the spectrometer, and click Collect. Wait a few seconds and click Stop. Repeat this, being sure to choose Save Latest Run with the patient's cuvette. Use the Examine tool to read your results at 500 nanometers. In this example, the patient's result is virtually equal to the standard. Notice that the data is color-coded. Here, the standard data is blue and the patient data is red. Refer to your lab manual and perform the calculations needed. You will be calculating the amount of HDL in milligrams per deciliter and then calculating the percent of HDL as part of the total cholesterol. The results should support what your spectra shows. Record and interpret your patient's results based on the values given in your laboratory notebook. Good luck, and thanks for watching.